Hello my friends, this is our next video on magnetic effect of current, and we already have uploaded three of the previous videos. This video is related with the 10th class CBSE board, and we presently is doing 13th chapter according to the NCERT book, and that is the magnetic effect of current as is seen here. So today we will cover a few topics like what is the magnetic force, magnetic lines of forces, and magnetic flux, and how they are different, right? So that is basically is a question that may arise into the mind of many people, like if magnetic flux and magnetic lines of forces both are related with magnetic field, then how they are basically different. So that we will try to find out, and also try to see what is a magnetic field, like that is our main concern. And apart from that, we will try to find out how an electric carrying current carrying conductor or a wire may behave when is placed in a magnetic field. So is there any force that can act on it, or what kind of phenomena can happen? So that we also try to look. Okay, so these are some of the things. So let us define what is a magnetic field. So we have seen here that if you have a magnet, something like that, so it always have a north pole and a south pole, we already have covered, and magnetic lines of forces are continuous in nature. So magnetic lines of forces may go from south to north inside the magnet, and from north to south outside the magnet, and that is the reason these are the continuous lines of forces. Similarly here also, so from south it enters and it leaves from the north pole of the magnet. Similarly like this, here also inside it is south to north, and outside is from north to south. So same kind of thing happens here also. Okay, and here also something like that. So magnetic lines of forces originate from the north pole of the magnet and leaves from the, and terminate to the south pole of the magnet. So that kind of things is there. We already have said that the magnetic lines of forces are continuous and cannot cross each other at any point. So these are the some simple things, we general things we already have seen and discussed. Now let us define what is a magnetic field. So what is a magnetic field? How any layman can define a magnetic field is, so it actually can be defined as an area. This area may be around a magnet, suppose this is a magnet, okay, or it can be an area around a wire, okay, in which some kind of current is moving. So when current I suppose is moving, so this current carrying wire will have a magnetic field around it. We already have said if it is current is moving upward in a wire, suppose current is moving upward, then the direction of magnetic field will be circular in a closed orbits, like as is shown in the figure, and it would be anti-clockwise, right, like this. Okay, similarly if suppose current is moving downward, So in that case also it would be in a circle like this, and that would be in clockwise direction, and that direction of the magnetic field can easily be found out. We already discussed in our previous videos that it can be found out by the Fleming's right hand thumb rule, right? So that we already have discussed. So what is the magnetic field? So magnetic field can be any area around a magnet or around a current carrying wire. Well, a current carrying wire can be a straight wire as is shown here, or it can be a circular as is shown here. It can be circular or it may be making some kind of a loop. So in that case, suppose current is moving in this direction, right? So the current is here like this. So here also some magnetic field would be around this one, okay, and some magnetic lines of forces may be like this, right? It may be going like this. So if is like that, so that can easily be found out that here the magnetic lines of force may be going here from here, and it is entering from here. So that is the magnetic lines of forces, which is represented by B, right? So there is another rule which is called Fleming's right hand palm rule. So palm rule also says that Fleming's right hand palm rule is for the current carrying circular or some wire which makes up any kind of a loop. So okay, so if some wire is making a loop, in that case Fleming's right hand palm rule can be used. So what is the Fleming's right hand palm rule? So Fleming's right hand palm rule, okay, so what it says, it basically says that if you have a circular wire, okay, current carrying wire, suppose this is the direction of the current, and if this is your suppose is your right hand, okay, and this basically I am making the palm of your hand, and this is suppose is the thumb of your hand, okay. So what is happening here is, if you keep the fingers or of your palm in the direction of the current of a circular loop, then the direction of your thumb would represent the magnetic field. So suppose there is a direction of current, that would be the magnetic field. So in that case, if I'll put palm here, okay, or here, so the direction of the magnetic field would be downward or inward, right? So magnetic field would be something like that. In that case, suppose here in this case would be something like that. So here the magnetic field is going inside, right? Something like that. So if you suppose put a palm, this suppose is the palm, my drawing may not be very good, and this is the thumb. So thumb direction would be inward, that would be the direction of the current, okay. So direction of your thumb basically would be inward. Likewise, if it means that if direction of current is clockwise, so the direction of magnetic field would be downward, okay. And if similarly direction of current is anti-clockwise like that, okay, and if you'll put the palm, so the direction of magnetic field would here in that case would be upward. So the magnetic field here would be upward, right? That is very straightforward. So in that case you may see that is the direction of the current. So in Fleming's right hand palm rule, you can say, if direction of current is anticlockwise, then direction of the magnetic field or magnetic lines of forces are upward, and you can say vice versa, right? It simply means is if the direction of current is clockwise, then it would be downward. Okay, so that can be replicated. If you'll compare it from the left hand rule, what it says in the case of the thumb rule, and in case of right hand palm rule, what it says, and how we can compare it, it is very straightforward. So when you write here Fleming's right hand palm rule, suppose that is the right hand thumb rule, and this is Fleming's right hand palm rule. So you can compare it in various ways. Here direction of current, suppose, was upward, then direction of magnetic field would have been what? Would have been, if it is upward, it would anticlockwise. Okay, anticlockwise. Where in this case, direction of current would be just you will replace with the, direction with the magnetic field. And if anticlockwise, if the direction of current is anticlockwise, the direction of magnetic field would be upward, right? So you can just say here the direction of magnetic field, suppose you represent by B, upward. Okay, it would be upward. Or current, if suppose is here, in this case current is downward. Okay, here it is just opposite of it, right? So magnetic field would be upward. Suppose if upward, then current is anticlockwise, right? So that is first thing. Other thing here is direction of current. If in the in case of right hand thumb rule, direction of current is downward, then direction of magnetic field is clockwise, right? And here in this case that is just opposite. So here direction of magnetic field downward, okay, then current is clockwise. So you just can see here current is replaced by the magnetic field, whereas the magnetic field here in this case, this is replaced by the current. Okay, and likewise here the direction of current, so here current is replaced by magnetic field, where the magnetic field here clockwise is replaced by the current, which is also clockwise. So in this way you can basically learn these two law and compare. So what we were doing before defining these two laws. This rule was the, we will try to define what was the magnetic field. So how can you define a magnetic field? So now, what is a magnetic field? Okay, so magnetic field basically is an area around, you can say around a magnet or a current carrying conductor. Okay, well, this conductor can be a wire, it can be a rod, metallic rod, or anything which is made of conductor is just carrying a current. Okay, so it is an area around a magnet, or it can be an area around a current carrying conductor, right? Conductor, where, what you can feel, where the magnetic needle experiences the deflection. Okay, so that is one of the things. If you will put a magnetic needle into an area, and into an area if you will put a magnetic needle, and in that area it experiences a deflection, so that is a magnetic field, right? So this field may be strong, it may be strong. Okay, so if deflection is very very rapid, okay, or vigorous deflection is there, sudden deflection, it means that the magnetic field or the magnetic field or the area, in that area magnetic field is very very strong, may be strong or may be weak. Okay, may be weak. So it means that the extent of your deflection by which magnetic needle gives a deflection, so that deflection can tell you about the intensity or weakness or strongness of that field, right? So that is the thing. Now, what is a magnetic field? Magnetic lines of forces. So when you put and how you can calculate the direction of a magnetic field, that is also an important thing. Suppose that is a current carrying wire, or it can be, suppose, is a magnet. So when you put a magnetic needle here, and I already said in previous lectures that needle itself is a small magnet mounted over a pivot. So here it is the north and here is the south. So when you put two small magnets, suppose that is a small magnet and that is a big magnet, so if I have a south here, so north pole of this small magnet would be attracted towards it. So likewise, if the north pole or the north of my needle is pointing here, suppose, it means here should be the south of this magnet. Okay, and it is very very evident that the magnetic lines of forces originates from the north and it goes towards the south. Okay, what does it mean? Here the south should be in this direction. Okay, similarly here also, right? Here also. So when you put a magnetic needle here, here in this case, so the tangent at this point, suppose this point is P, tangent at this point where this needle is kept, that gives the direction of the magnetic field. Okay, so the direction, you can write direction of the magnetic field or magnetic lines of forces can be found out by the tangent at a point, tangent at a point on a magnetic lines of force, okay, on a magnetic lines of forces. So this is how you can calculate the direction of magnet. Suppose here I'll put a magnetic needle here also. Suppose that point is Q. So if I'll draw a tangent to this point, okay, so that will give me the direction of the magnetic field. It means that if I'll put a magnet here, so the north pole of my small needle would be in this direction, right, as is the direction of this tangent. So that would be the direction of the magnetic field, right. Now next question that arises is, what is a flux, right, and how it is different from a magnetic field. So what is a magnetic flux? That is the another question. So magnetic flux in very simple terms is just the total total magnetic lines of forces passing through, okay, so these are the magnetic lines of forces passing through an area, okay, perpendicular or normal to the lines of forces or the magnetic lines of forces. Okay, so that basically is very very important definition, and this magnetic flux is represented by a symbol phi. Okay, so what it means and how it is different, and what is magnetic field, by the way, and how you can say B, which is the strength of magnetic field, B, how B, strength of magnetic field, is different from magnetic flux. So that we will try to find. Okay, so now the question arises is, how we'll calculate the strength of a magnetic field. So suppose I have a magnet here, okay, I have a magnet here, and this magnet has a north pole and a south pole. So magnetic lines of forces should go like this, something like that. So magnetic lines of forces should go from the north and come towards the south. When you see outside the magnet, okay, inside it is going from south to the north, right. So when you see this magnet, okay, then you can easily find out that there are certain regions where magnetic lines of forces are dense, and in other regions magnetic lines of forces are very very rare. So there are some rare fractions, and here it is very dense, right. So here magnetic lines of forces are very dense, right, or densely populated. Okay, but when you see this portion, for example this portion, so here only one or two magnetic lines may be crossing, and in this small area a lot of magnetic lines of forces is crossing. So when you try to calculate the magnetic flux, suppose that is the magnetic flux phi A of that region, and that is the magnetic flux of B, so the total number of lines of forces here in this case is how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 lines of forces for an example, and here it is just 2. So the magnetic flux at this point and at this point is different, right. And what is the magnetic field then? So magnetic lines of forces, and what you see here, the deflection is very slow in the magnetic needle in this area, reflection in the magnetic needle is very very slow, whereas in this case it is very very vigorous. Okay, vigorous. It is shaking very vigorously here in this case, but here the shaking of the magnetic needle is very slow. It's not deflecting very vigorously. Okay, so it means that the magnetic strength, if we will try to calculate, here in this case is very less, and here in this case phi a is very very high as compared to this. It means that the magnetic field intensity or B must depend somehow on not only the magnetic lines of forces but on the area, where in this case if you see the region B, here the area is very large as compared to A, but the magnetic lines of force is very very less. Okay, here in this case area is very high but the magnetic field is very 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 less area, but the magnetic field is very high because of the many more number of lines of forces present there. Okay, so magnetic field intensity here in this case means magnetic field intensity in case of A and magnetic field intensity in case of point B. So B is less as compared to A. Okay, and why is so? Because magnetic lines of forces here is very large. That is the one thing. Another thing you can see here is the intensity of magnetic lines of forces here is decreasing as you are going away from this magnet, right? Whereas the magnetic field intensity here point A is very large because it is very nearer to the magnet. So that is another point. So so intensity B first is depends on the number of magnetic lines of forces. Okay, that is one thing. Second, B also depends on the density of the magnetic field of the magnetic lines of force. Okay, lines of force. And third, that is very visible from here is magnetic field intensity is inversely proportional to the distance. If suppose R is the distance, but it is not quite inversely proportional to R, it is square of the R. Okay, so these are some of the things we had we must know, right? So now we will just conclude this video, and if you like this video, please press the like button, and please subscribe our channel and press the bell icon so that the future videos when we will be uploading will come to you at first. I'm sure that if you'll subscribe our channel, you will find more interesting videos of your kind. So thank you for watching. Thank you very much.